I was born. Looks all that around. They gazed to the wild wonder at the joy they had found. Then they spoke up to leave this little alone. She could tell right away that I was bad as a bone. Bad as a bone. Bad as a bone. Bad as a bone.
I want to tell you something. Midnight Express and you mama boy cornet, the whip that you are, you've been running roughshod over everybody, but not my street people, baby. I'm taking my man underneath the Boogie Woogie's wing, Jack.
All right, let's show you, Vance, let's show you exactly what Jimmy Vance talking about. All right, there it is, Jimmy.
Right there, there's a perfect shot. They hit the 1-2-3 right there on the young kid. And then they took advantage of my brother right there. Now look at this. Here's the Midnight Express. And here's the whip. Here is the whip, the mama's boy. It took two people to hold this boy. This boy right here's got more hop in himself than all three of them put together. Davey Crocker, look at that. Look at that. Taking a man's pride. Taking it right off from him, brother. There's nobody. That does that to a street brother, and I don't care who it is. Rocky King, hold that head up high, brother. Hold that head up high with your brother. We're gonna do it together. You know, I wanna tell you a little story, real short and fast. One time when I was a boy growing up in the streets of New York City, listen to this, Rocket. When I was growing up, there was a man. He had one blue eye and one brown eye, and they were crossed, and he did look a little funny. Well, they took a lot of advantage of this man. He was a young man, and you know what, Davy Crockett? I saved this man many times. He was just a regular guy to me. Well, he turned out to be a millionaire, you understand? And he's done a lot for the boogeyman. Now, I won't want nothing. I don't want nothing. I didn't do that for something either. I don't want nothing for my street brother. But I got him. We're together. He's under my wing. We'll see ya, Crockett. We will see the Midnight Express and the whip. We'll get them.
Minutes, we're going to have a match with Abdullah the Butcher, managed by Paul Jones, a man that would like to get hold of Abdullah the Butcher and Paul Jones, the Raging Bull, Manny
Fernandez. You know
something,
Davy Crockett, all along the lines of the road to stardom, there's always lumps and bumps. There's always something rocking and rolling trying to get in your way. And in my way stands 462 pounds. You know, someday, I would like to accomplish the goal to be number one contender for that world title and be something. Abdullah the Butcher, you're standing in my way, Daddy, and you're one big load. And I'm not saying you're a massive man, Daddy. I'm saying you're awesome trouble. And I deal with apes because I am the Beastmaster. And nobody does it better than the Bull. And it's a long, rocky road to the top. And I plan to get there, Davy Crockett. I plan to be a legend of my own time. And the Weasel and Abdullah the Butcher are standing in my way. And nothing gets in the way of the Bull once he starts raging. Ain't that right, Lee? Because, baby, when I get together, it's coming down that road. You're flirting with disaster, Daddy, and disaster is awesome. And when the Bull gets awesome, it's totally, for sure, tubular, for real. And I'm going to start rocking and rolling. And Abdullah the Butcher, heed my warning, baby, because the Bull is coming out. Full out, baby, to prove one point. I am going to be a legend in my time. So, Abdullah, gear up anywhere in the world. Mexican death match, any cage, any kind you want. The Bull is going to suplex you all over the ring, and I'm going to take it to you.
All right, we heard from the Bull. Now in the ring, Abdullah Butcher with Paul Jones. Hey, Tony, the man I'm talking about, the Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez. You heard him. He's got a lot of words.
David, he really does, and he claims he will suplex the big man, and I believe if there's one man in the sport that could pick up this man over 460 pounds and suplex him, it would be the Raging Bull.
You are right. But look at the mass. Look at this man, the human tank, Abdul the Butcher. Paul Jones has surrounded himself by two of the biggest men in wrestling, the Barbarian and Abdul the Butcher. We're watching now just one of his men. And what a man he is. Look at Jones.
You know, we talked about the suplex that the Raging Bull said he could put on Abdul the Butcher. The Butcher doesn't concern himself with suplexes, with arm bars, with arm drags. He concerns himself only with beating a man, with punishing a man. Look here. That right big fist.
He has it taped the whole time. That makes that fist a lot harder. This is the fans they're calling Weasel.
You can hear the chant of Weasel. And look here.
Look at him go right for the mouth, pulling at it, ripping. I'll remind you fans right now, all young fans out there, these men are professionals. Do not try anything that you see right here on television. Enjoy watching it. If you want to wrestle, go through the amateur ranks. Because these guys are pros. Don't try any of them. Any of the holds, please. All right, the Butcher picks him up. Look at him. Bends him across the ropes. Stretches those muscles. Look at Jones. Very, very confident. Headbutt by the Butcher. He rams, he goes out. Now watch Jones. Watch out for him. Rams him in that corner post. The Butcher's there waiting.
Paul Jones. He really acts innocent when referee Tommy Young is keeping a watchful eye on him, but he is anything but innocent at ringside. Once again, David. David, obviously, that blow has to be a legal blow, or is it?
As long as the referee doesn't see it.
You know, it looks like, and I'm talking about the right hand by the Butcher.
No, he has that tape on there, and I think it makes it very rigid. Watch out. Watch out. Here he goes. Look at him. Look at him. That 400 plus pounds right down on Lee Ramsey. And that is it.
There's no doubt about it for the opening bell that that one man of destruction, Abdul the Butcher, would win the match.
Look at Jones.
David, that was over 600 pounds right down on Lee Ramsey after Paul Jones had stood. See the flying elbow by Abdul the Butcher as he wins the match. The winner of the match, Abdul the Butcher, with number one, Paul Jones.
Let's take time out.
You have an extra. Do you lose something?
Hey, listen, American, if I want any garbage from you, I'll rip your head off and help myself.
Hey, you don't have your protector.
This is my interview time.
All right.
Idea. And I've been addressing it right to Ric Flair. You know, right now, Crusher and Nikita are in gymnasium working out, getting bigger, getting stronger than ever. We will not be denied. The road to Moscow will be paved in gold, David Crockett.
Wait a minute. Your guys are working out so hard. Are you saying that the Americans are stronger than your men? And that's why they have to work out and become stronger?
Everybody throughout the world knows that the Russian athlete is superior in every sport, David Crockett. Just like Ric Flair knows it. For evading Nikita for one whole year. Then he gets enough guts to sign a contract against Nikita. Then he picks his referees, prejudiced referees. Then another occasion, he gets his American friends to help him. People like Dusty Rhodes to assist him. But I know Dusty Rhodes. I know Dusty Rhodes. Why? Because you know Dusty Rhodes, that you judges try to wrestle world title away from this Ric Flair rather than try to wrestle away from nephew Nikita. Because he is stronger than you, more powerful than you, and Ric Flair is going to find it out.
I'm not arguing Nikita is stronger, but there is a question about being smarter. Hey, you know, strength is not everything.
You know,
you've got to have the brains to go with it.
You know, it's going to be proven,
wait a minute,
David
Johnson.
He's in the
ring. You're always outside the ring.
Why don't you shut your mouth for 1 minute? This is my interview time when I come out here. And we will not be denied. There will be a place, a situation, where Ric Flair will not be able to deny Nikita taking world title away from
him.
And if people like Dusty Rhodes want to stick their nose in it, he's going to be stripped of his world TV title. And that goes for any other American.
The three of you guys jump on someone, of course they're going to help.
You know, the Rock and Roll felt what it's like to be hung by this chain. And they had the stupidity to go out and sign a contract against us. To try to, they said if we want the chain
you
back again,
you thought they were crazy for challenging for the
they
world
said
tag
if
title.
We want to take
the
chain away from them.
Now. They, maybe they're not
those
crazy.
Belts belong to us, David Crockett, just like that chain belongs to me. It was given to me by an old dear friend of mine, a comrade Yoakum, years ago, and I merely.
Rocky King. You know, Jimmy Valiant said he would take Rocky King under his wing and show Rocky King what needs to be done. And Rocky King, as you stand right there at ringside, and I can't think of two better men than the Raging Bull and Jimmy Valiant to show a youngster like Rocky King what it takes.
That is right.
And you're right, David. The fans erupted like a volcano when Jimmy Valiant's music started, and look at the bull.
Look at him. Look at him. Chop him.
Like you said, two men that you'd like to have on your side. The Raging Bull, Manny Fernandez, and the Boogie Woogie Man, Jimmy Vance. Remember what Fernandez said about Abdullah the Butcher? He's going to pick him up, and he's going to suplex him. I want Jim Cornette with the Midnight Express to think about that.
Paul Jones always surrounds himself with more than one man. So Jimmy Vance had to go out and get himself another man.
Right between the eyes.
Jimmy Valiant, one thing about him, baby, he'll pull anything to put the man down, won't he?
Yes, he will.
I mean, he has been known to hit him in the throat, to pull the head, to punch him in the eyes, anything at all.
Look at it. They double team. Valiant gets out before the count. The bull lumbers over. Snapmare. Backed up in the ropes. Here he comes. With a knee right across the head.
Once again, let us remind you, Rocky King is at ringside with the Boogeyman and the Raging Bull. And what humiliation. What a degrading thing that Jim Cornette and the Midnight Express did to that youngster.
That is correct. But, hey, with a man like Jimmy Valiant and the Raging Bull helping this young man, I think Mr. Cornette is going to have a rude awakening. Hey, you know what's helping this man, too? This whole team of Jimmy Vant and the Raging Bull, these fans. Because I tell you what, when they're yelling and screaming, these guys click.
Let us remind you briefly, still to become the World Heavyweight Champion, Nature Boy Ric Flair, and the World Tag Team Champions, the Rock and Roll Express.
The National Tag. And also the National Tag Team Champions, the Minnesota Rick. Hey, look at him. He's biting his fingers.
David, also U.S. Heavyweight Champion Tully Blanchard, superstar playground. Champion will be here. Dusty Rhodes. Midnight Express. Kick. The ball gets him. Drives his knees right into the back. The leg. In the hamstrings. He goes over, twisting. David Cuomo, a spinning toe hold right there. He just locks that foot. America's team will be with us. Dusty Rhodes and Magnum TA.
World Heavyweight Champion. Woo! You understand? Don't need to be wearing a hat when your name is Ric Flair. I don't need to be coming out here taking off my clothes. Because you see, I don't like to take off my clothes unless someone's paying $25 and sitting ringside to see this. This is the toughest piece of work in wrestling today. Woo! Slick Rick! You know, if I go through the airport, I'll say, woo! Hit that walk, ain't you, boy! Woo! Hit that walk! Because I'm the man! I heard Manny Fernandez out here saying, he's gonna be a legend of all time. Well, Manny, you are looking at someone. Don't try to be a legend. He is a legend. Dusty Rhodes, you're a country talking fool.
Woo! All right, ladies and gentlemen, you see them, the National Tag Team Champions, the Andersons, the Minnesota Wrecking Crew, and then you see United States Heavyweight Champion Tully Blanchard and his perfect 10 baby dolls. Across the ring, Ron Rousey, Gerald Finley, and Vernon Deaton. Finley's in there. He has Iron Anderson. Anderson quickly, suplex, goes down. Look at him. Starts to pound away, trying to drive him into that mat. You know, we mentioned about the irate Arn Anderson because of what Sam Houston did to him, pinned him last week, and I think here's proof of it right here. Look at it.
Look at him.
Taking all three men on. The man is still upset.
Oh, he's mad. He's ticked off.
Because Sam Houston beat, I mean beat, Arn Anderson. One half of the Minnesota Wrecking Crew pinned him down on the mat. And look at the Anderson, Ole Anderson. The Rock. Has that arm. He goes back to that pattern. They want the arm or any part of the body. And they start to work on it. They start to drive and pull and twist. Vernon Deaton now in. Ole grabs him. Yells for the foot. United States Heavyweight Champion Tully Blanchard comes in. There you see Baby Doll. Deaton trying to fight him. Tully taking those punches. Catching him. You know, Tully, they get him the Anderson philosophy. You take 10 punches to get one good punch in. Yeah, what he's done.
That's right. That is their philosophy. They'll take 10. Give me one punch is what Ole says. Speaking of Ole, there he is, David.
Ole takes him. Rolls him back in. United States champion. Tully grabs him. Now Iron. The man that's got to be upset, irate. He's got revenge in his heart. Look at him. Shoulder breaker. Doesn't try to pin him. Starts to pound away. Again and again, off the ropes. Snapmare takes him over. Tag. Ole Anderson. Ole comes in. Gets him the foot right in the chest. Picks him up. Slamming. They're trying to... No attempt to make that pin. David. Tully Blanchard looking over towards us. You see him on the right of your screen. And the fans are really into this match, and it's so loud, but I think I could make out that he was talking about America's team. He was wondering, where is America's team now? That's what he was saying, and he was talking about Dusty and Magnum. Hey, part of America's team, I'm talking about the young prodigy, Sam Houston, got Arn Anderson. Look at Arn. As Rossi takes him down. Stretching that arm, pulling it. Tully comes in. Across the elbow, across that chest. And he grabs it. Look at him. Look at him go to work on it. Twisting, pulling at it.
Baby doll, you can see her clapping, all smiles. There you see her. Her man, Shelly Blanchard. Getting Helena Rossi.
David, the look on his face also.
There you see her. She's got a little smirk on her face.
Yeah, she's very happy.
Arn Anderson back in. They certainly are really, you know, they're good because they're champions, but as a six-man combination, they're excellent.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
they are. Excellent. They have served to everyone. When they go in a match, they go in for a submission. They don't want to pin you. They want to make you submit, to take you, punish you, pulverize you, and finally humiliate you and make you submit. Watch them. A wrestling machine. The Andersons and Charlie Blanchard. Look at them. Watch what they do to their opponent. Kelly pacing across, you know, the little catch thing. Now he goes after all three men.
Something that Arn did at the beginning of the match.
You know, they've let Arn in most of this match to let him take out his frustrations. What's Kelly going to do to him? He's got him up.
Slingshot right here.
Slingshot, yep. A slingshot, suplex. Two, three, and that's it. Look at him. Look at the confidence in this man. The whole team.
They have reason to be confident. Their win record as a six-man combination has been very impressive. And they all three are champions. We're going to take a look once again at the end of the match. The slingshot suplex from the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Kelly Blanchard, as he teams with the Andersons to win this match. Coming up next, superstar Billy Graham, the Rock and Roll Express, and more. Don't go away.
James J. Dillon.
You should have introduced us as James J. Dillon, the manager of champions, and the most sought-after attraction in all of professional sports today, not only in the world of professional wrestling. I'm talking about the Nature Boy, Buddy Landell. And I know we have a great following throughout all of West Virginia, and particularly here in Willing. I get a lot of fan mail saying, when is the Nature Boy, Buddy Landell, coming to town? Well, I've given the promoters an open contract Thursday, October 10th. They're saying it's going to be a super night of NWA wrestling action. And when you talk about NWA superstars, right up at the top of the list has to be Nature Boy Buddy Landell. So I've given an open contract to the promoters. Now the rest is up to them. I've called their bluff. And I think they're going to have a real problem trying to find somebody that's willing to step up, put their name on the line, and say, I'm ready to try the Nature Boy on for size, because he's gone through all the competition like a hot knife through butter. So Cowboy Ron Bass, the man that I created years ago, took him to great heights, almost took him to the top, till his jealous eyes of the Nature Boy overcame his good judgment. Maybe Bass wants to step forward and try the Nature Boy on for size, because I like to see him have a little bit of humility, because that's what he needs. And there's a few other people. Magnum T.A., the so-called young lion of wrestling, the superstar, the man that everybody's talking about, he could step up and put his name on the contract, too. And let's not forget the world television champion, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. He's had that title long enough. And when you talk about television superstars, you've got to talk about Nature Boy Buddy Landell. Wheeling, West Virginia, we're calling your bluff. Step forward. Come to the front of the line. Put your name on the contract, because we're ready to come to town.
You want the real thing? Here it is. Superstar Billy Graham. Often imitated, but never, and I repeat, never duplicated.
Oh, that's it, Davy Crockett. Nobody can imitate superstar Billy Graham, the most colorful man in all of wrestling. Now, don't adjust your fine tuner on your television. You're looking at the multicolor, multicolor superstar Billy Graham. You can get a close-up, Mr. Kimman. That's right. Superstar Billy Graham got 9 earrings on. And pretty soon, by every matter of fact, a 12-year-old boy, that day, said, superstar, I want to look like you when I grow up. I want some earrings in my ears, and I want a 24-inch python on my arm. I'm going to start pumping iron and wearing earrings just like Superstar Billy Graham. Superstar Billy Graham is bad. He's bad to the bone. Python, a Superstar Billy Graham. I am the greatest. I am the strongest. And Nature Boy Slick Ric Flair, you're going to have to deal with Superstar Billy Graham sooner or later. And tell you bad news, Blanchard, Mr. USA, got the USA United States Championship. You got to face a superstar in the American dream. I need your belt for television, brother. I am the world television, most colorful man of all of television. I need your belt to make me complete.
Dimitri's going to do against superior athletes such as Nikita and Crusher. Nothing. We're going to get our chain back, and we're going to get our world tag team belt back.
A man that is very, very confident in himself because he has his mother behind him. Also, he has two men that the best that money can buy. But now that you've...
This is the longest you've ever gone that I didn't disagree with you. Do you know that?
Well, let me finish then. Since you are agreeing with me and I'm agreeing with you, that I think you did something wrong.
What?
I think you slapped the wrong man. Because Jimmy Vance... Now, right?
You want me to try somebody else, David Crockett? Is that what you're itching for? No, let me tell you something. First of all, I'm sure.
Yeah.
Let me say one word, first of all, about the so-called champions, the Rock and Roll Express. Everybody's so impressed with them in rock and roll. I will give you this. You are the greatest team in professional wrestling, with the exception of the Midnight Express. And you know that we're the one team that can take you. The two top teams in wrestling, they got to meet sooner or later once you get the guts. Now, you talk about Rocky King and Jimmy Boogie Woogie Man Bay, the odd couple. I thought they banned Amos and Andy off television 20 years ago. Pretty soon, Boogie Woogie Man's going to be working for the Fresh Air Taxi Cab Company. Rocky King going to be walking up. Let me tell you something, boss. We're going to go down to the pool hall. We're going to see them boys. You know, I'm sick of this stuff. Rocky King, you're a nobody. You're a bum, just like all the people out here, all the people watching at home that don't like the Midnight Express are bums. Nobody's, they're not going anywhere in life. You got nothing going for you except a weirdo like Jimmy Boogie Woogie Man Bad, who wants to take you under his wing. Who knows what's else been under that wing? All I got to say about Jimmy Vaillant, I've maintained for a long time that he needs a blood test. But I'll tell you one thing, Vaillant, you picked the wrong place to stick that big, ugly, altered nose of yours, because when you stick your nose in Cornette's business, that's when you get it slapped right straight off your face. And you know who does the slapping? Loverboy Dennis and Beautiful Bobby, the Midnight Express, who, like I just said a minute ago, are the greatest tag team in professional wrestling.
Are you afraid to try to slap Jimmy?
Hey, I'll slap Jimmy Vaillant's face. Is he around here anywhere? Huh? Is he behind the set? Is he? I'll slap his face. I'll slap your face, Jimmy Vaillant. I'll slap Rocky King's face. I will slap the face of anybody I want to slap, because I've said before, if you got a complaint with me, then take it to my complaint department, the Midnight Express. They'll be more than happy to process you.
Ladies and gentlemen, America's team, Magnum, TA, and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes.
David, it's always a great opportunity, pleasure to be right out here, Jack, because this is what it's all about. And let me tell you something, Maggie May, myself, you talk about Ole Anne Anderson, talking about Sam Houston, taking a beautiful, pretty victory, Daddy, pretty victory over Double A Ian Anderson. Now then, got to turn their attention to what it's all about, the World Television Champion and the rightfully United States Heavyweight Champion, Magnum T.A. Jacket. It's going to happen.
Magnum.
That's where we get down to brass tacks now. Tully Blanchard running around, real proud, saying he's defending his title time and time again against me. He's saying in no disqualification matches, he's walked out the victor. But look at each and every place, look at each and every incident, Tully Blanchard. You had somebody come down, you had some interference, something saved you on every particular incident. Now, I know that I've got my work cut out for me, because I know how devious a person you are. I know about your association with the Andersons, and I know that they'll stop at nothing to get what they want. And they want a piece of me. They want a piece of the American dream. And anytime they have the chance to interfere with us, they get it done. Well, Tully Blanchard, that United States heavyweight title is the most coveted title in the NWA today. Outside the World Television title and the NWA World's heavyweight title held by Ric Flair, the Nature Boy. So you just remember this. Whatever it takes, I'll get as nasty, I'll get as dirty, I'll do whatever I have to do to get the job done myself, because I'm the man that deserves to hold that belt.
All right, I want America's team to stay here because we had the Midnight Express in the ring. Let's hear from Jim Cornette.
Who's the greatest tag team in professional wrestling, huh? That's right. You know the answer. Loverboy Dennis, Beautiful Bobby, here they are, the Midnight Express.
Dennis and Beautiful Bobby. They're in there against Starship Eagle and Mac Jeffers. With me, Dusty Rhodes and Magnum CA. Dusty, what about this team?
I'll tell you what, they're an awesome sight, but I tell you, I get a big kick out of Jim Cornette out here talking about slapping people around and Jimmy Valiant being a street man that he is, talking about Rocky King and Amos and Andy and everything. It's going to be real funny when Jimmy the Boogie Woogie Man Valiant holds Jim Cornette and Rocky King slaps his face.
That is right. Now, Loverboy Dennis. What we've seen a lot of times with the Midnight Express, they quickly move in and out. That teamwork. Watch them now.
What I see here is two men that work very well together. The machine that you see right here. Starship Eagle, big man, 6'6". That's where the standing drop kick that knocked this man right down the mat. So these men can be had, but they always have that added advantage on the outside of the ring. They always have that cocky Jim Cornette standing out there trying to pull off some type of diversion to enable them to get back in the driver's seat. And on each and every occasion I've seen this particular incident take place.
Beautiful Bobby. Anthony Mott, suplex. Short, quick, and sweet.
Another thing about him, David Crockett, the other day out here mentioned Rock and Roll Express. Talking about Boogeyman, Jimmy Valiant, Rocky King, I'd say, but they failed to mention America's team, Dusty Rhodes and Magnum T.A. There must be a reason for that.
Here he goes. Good move by Mac Jeffers. Beautiful Bobby. He has it. Bobby, elbow to the top of the head. Captain him with a knee right in that midsection. Takes him down.
One thing that all great teams have, these two kids got here is teamwork. That's it. They've been together a long time, many years. You can see it. They are managed by one of the most awesome people, one of the most awesome talkers, I might add, that I've ever seen my life. And that's Jim Cornette, Mama's Boy, Boogie Woogie Man. So they're going to have to deal with a lot of teams before they get the Rock and Roll Express, because nobody came on the scene, took it by the horns like the Rock and Roll Express did when they beat Ivan Tusha Khrushchev for the World Tag Team title.
Watch him. Here he goes. He does this very well. Off that top rope. Diving elbow right into the chest. Beautiful Bobby. He is something. I tell you what, Jim Cornette spent his money well when he bought this team.
Yes, he did. You can't take anything away from these men's wrestling ability to be able to execute that type of move with that type of accuracy and then follow it up with that devastating clothesline with a very phenomenal feat in himself. You can't take anything away from the Midnight Express. They are a team that's going to have to be dealt with, but there's plenty of teams around here that are capable of dealing with it.
Went awful bad to take his head off. Because I tell you what, this team is something. It really is something. All right, let's watch it now. Here it comes. Wait a second, what's going on here? Hey, Tony. Terry Taylor just came over and said something bad happened to Sam.
He's talking about who?
All right, Tony, I need to go find, guys, listen. Tony, get over here. I need to find out what happened. All right, come on now. I need to go and find out what happened. Here, you go ahead and take this. All right, come on.
All right, David, go ahead. Go ahead and see what happened. Terry Taylor came right up here to ringside, and I have no idea what happened, but Terry Taylor came right up to ringside and said something happened, something bad happened to Sam Houston, and I have no idea what they were talking about, but we were in the process of showing you the match, or the end of the match in slow motion with a Midnight Express defeating their opponents, Starship Eagle and Mac Jeffers. David Crockett has gone somewhere, either in the building here or maybe outside of the building, and I think we're going to have David Crockett. There he is right now. There he is right now outside. David? David Crockett is outside right now.
Back away, Jim. Back away.
Let's go. Come on, get
back away.
No.
Back away. I got to get a mic. Let's see if I can find a mic. Come on.
My goodness, what is going on anyway? That is outside, and that is right behind the building.
That's in the parking lot. Let's see if we can get a word from David. There you see Dusty Rhodes. There you see Terry Taylor.
Can y'all hear me?
Terry Taylor. All right, let's see if we can go to David Crockett. David?
Hi.
Hey, guys.
Hi. David, what is going on out there?
So we can get the camera over. They're taking Dusty Rhodes, Magnum. They're taking Sam Houston in. Into the room.
This is not pretty at all.
What happened to him? I'm not sure. All right. They're taking him into the dressing room now. What they're telling me in the truck. All right, ladies and gentlemen. You saw what happened to Sam Houston. They jumped him. The fan said, you know who jumped him? The Andersons. That's right, Ole and Iron Anderson. I didn't see it. We didn't see it. But all of us around here said, Tully Blanchard. They say they jumped him. Tully Blanchard, Ole and Iron Anderson.
Only come out first.
They jumped.
And then they jump on my.
This young man, the young man, part of America's team, a prodigy of them, they're the ones. They wanted him. Sam Houston beat Iron Anderson fair and square. And look what they did to him. They jumped him out here. Sam Houston, this young man, he's in there right now. I don't know what's wrong with him or what's happened to him right now. But ladies and gentlemen, the Andersons, they couldn't stand it. Iron Anderson couldn't stand it. Tully Blanchard, Ole Anderson, and Iron Anderson. Those guys. Something's got to be done about it. Sam Houston, we need to find... I'm going to see if I can find out what's happening to him. Sam Houston, but we're with him. Let's see. All right, I'm going in and checking on him.